Hello all, welcome to my YouTube channel Being an Art Lover. In today's video, we are going to make this beautiful coaster. If you are new to my channel, please do subscribe and press the notification button. If you like my video, please give a thumbs up and do share with your friends. Without delay, let's get into the video. To make this beautiful coaster, I have taken this MDF as the base material. On this, I'll be applying gesso. Once it's completely dry, then we'll start working on this. Okay guys, you can see our base coat is completely dry. Now let's take the cutting out of this decoupage napkin. I'm going to use this section of flower on this MDF base. Let's just tear it out. I'm using my fingers only. You can use scissors or you can apply water and you can tear them. In one of my previous video, I have given an insight about this decoupage napkin and why we are using fingers to tear it everything. If you want to know or if you're curious to learn about this, you can just check it out the video. The link is given in the description. Even I'll be giving them in the I button. Now you can see I have taken the design. Let me check the alignment. I think the center portion will go good. Okay, let's stick this on our MDF base. For that, I'm going to take an help of this flat brush and I'm going to use this decoupage glue. Again, this is from Itsy Bitsy and there are various other options also available in the market. If you're willing to purchase any of them, I'll be giving the link in description. You can just check it out. First, I'll apply this decoupage glue on the base. Then we'll stick this napkin on the base. But most important thing, as I said before in my previous video, there will be a thin layer behind this decoupage napkin. You have to remove them before you stick them on the any surface. This decoupage napkin is very thin in nature, so you have to be very careful while handling them. So you can see I'm just removing the sheet. It's a very transparent and thin sheet, so be very careful while working with it. Just give a gentle press all over so that wrinkles will not be formed. You will get a very good finishing. We have to apply this decoupage glue on the surface too. While applying, you may feel like it's giving you a whitish shape, but once it's completely dry, they'll be transparent. And the one I'm using here is from Itsy Bitsy of matte look. So it will give you a matte look. If you want a glossy one, you can go with it. That is also available in the market. Let's give time for the glue to dry completely. Then we'll go to the next step. Now you can see our coaster is completely dry. Now I'm going to use this sponge. You can use a normal sponge and I'm going to apply this metallic color, the brown shade, on this coaster. I'm not going to use this metallic color all over. I'm going to cover this white colored portion around this leaf and flowers with this shade. I'm just dabbing the color. Don't take too much excess of color. Just take only required amount. Be careful when you are working to the border section of the designs. In the same way, with the help of sponge, I have given this golden shade around the flower. So, and it's completely dry. Now I'm going to apply the crackle medium only on the golden surface. So I have already done a detailed video on this crackle medium. If you want to know more about this, you can check in the description. The link of the video is given and I'll be giving in the I button too. I'm going to apply the crackle medium with the help of this flat brush. I'll be applying one step crackle medium only on the golden part of the coaster. I'm applying a thin layer of one step crackle medium. This is from again Itsy Bitsy and it's also available in Amazon. So I'll be giving the link of the products used in this video. You can purchase them from there. Okay, done with applying the crackle medium. Let it dry. Once it's dry, I'll be giving a pink shade on it. Once our crackle medium is completely dry, as I said before, I have given a pink shade wherever I have used a crackle medium. I'm really sorry because I missed the video where I applied this paint on the crackle medium. I have used the shade of Rose Blossom from Itsy Bitsy. It's a chalk paint. So I have used this on the coaster. Wherever I have applied a crackle medium, I have given a top shade with this one. So you can see the crackles which is formed and it's completely dry. So moving to our last step, we have to protect our artwork. So I'm going to use this Little Birdie matte finish varnish on the coaster. Let's apply it with the help of a flat brush. Whenever it comes for the artwork, you put all your effort and time and you do it. It's most important to protect them. So I have also done a detailed video on types of varnishes and their different usages. I'll be giving the link of that video in description. You can just check it out and it will be given in the I button too. So done with applying varnish. Let it dry completely. Once it's dry, it's ready to use. And here is the final look, guys. Hope you all enjoy today's video. If you really like it, please give a thumbs up and do share with your friends. If you're new to my channel, please do subscribe and press the notification button so that you'll not miss any of my upcoming videos. And start following me in Instagram. My Instagram ID is being an art lover. If you're willing to purchase any of my artwork, you can DM to my Instagram or else you can visit my shop in Love from Bharat. The link of the website is given in description. Please do check it. Thank you.